Okay, so today is February the 28th, week 3, but week 1 of the program, and day 3, which means we're going to be doing some chest and back, and just like the other days now, we're going to be dropping down to 15s, repetition-wise, and yeah. Okay, you guys, so just going to do a little warm-up here for chest. I did not weigh myself today or yesterday, but anyways, this is going to come off. Lower back muscles right here and in here have been tender and tight, mainly because for the last, I would say, 3-4 months on my climb-up days for legs, I've been going high repetitions and climbing up. So I think it's just taxed that area a little bit more, and that's why I'm doing my upside down stretching, incorporating more reverse hypers, and I think this climb-up day on Saturday, I'm just gonna couple times where I'm not climbing up on the high reps like that. I gotta calm down the little bit of the inflammation in that area, and that's okay. Sometimes you know, we're gonna work around any injuries. If you get a shoulder injury, start training on one side only. These things happen, but anyways, I'm just sharing that with you. So, if you see me sitting up like this, that takes pressure off the lower back. Instead of keeping it torqued like that, I mean, yeah, I could do it, like, but I feel good. So we'll do another warm-up set. So as we start to lower the rep ranges and climb up on the weight, we start to incorporate some more warm-up exercises to that weight. At least that's what I do. So first one was just the bar, so just a quick bumper, but to the what we're going to be working with. Thank you. step number one. But yeah, feeling like a 10 man today. Okay, step number two. Yeah, super tight in that lower back, very tender. So this is gonna show you all these muscles in here, okay? So I gotta smarten up, and we're gonna hang upside down again, do some stretching. Stiffness. It fucking sucks. Okay, now we're on incline press. One of those days. Fuck you, bar. Okay. Nice. Okay, so before I was doing 95 for 20s, now I'm doing 115 for 15s. I mean, I could have went 105 maybe, but fuck it. Oh. I'll tell you, this incline seat, oh, the way my back, it's all tense. Sitting like this feels amazing. So if you find yourself in a position where you feel amazing, use it, especially if your back's tight. So you can sit here, pull your legs up and stretch. Okay. But if you're in a position where you're sitting on the couch and then you go to get up and you're really sore, don't sit in that position anymore. Don't sit on that couch until your back's better. Instead, lay down with your legs up on a cushion, like that, kind of flattened out on the thing. Last night I slept with pillows underneath my legs like that. Or if you're a side sleeper, sleep with the pillows in between your legs on your side. It'll relieve the pressure off your back, and that's what you want. Now imagine if I didn't train and my back is out of whack. Fuck all that. All right, nice 15s, okay? Percentage of body fat I'm at. Anybody take a guess? I don't know what percentage. I'll have to try those calipers. Doing 50 for 320s. On this exercise, I'll move up to 60. And if I feel like jumping up to 70, we'll see, but we'll just do 60 today, maybe. That stretch is really good. Thank you. Last time we were doing 80 for 320s, now we're gonna go 90s for 315s. First, just warm up with a little 60 here. Friday's climb up, I did 110 for 35 on these, and then over to the rows for 110 for 35s, and then 50 pounds for 35. So, look, the lighter days make sense. Recuperation, but you're still training. So I'm gonna do 90 today, just for 315s. That's it. Because look, Friday we did the climb up day on those. So that's what, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, 4 days rest. Nice maintenance workout, okay? And then we're not gonna be training heavy for another climb up day till, you know, not this Friday, but the following. So all good. The body needs time to recover. The body needs time to recover to get to these, to climb up and hit the numbers. Just watch, you'll see. I've done this before with powerlifting, so I'm just, yeah. Main thing is getting this shit off. Set number two. Back, all in here, your butt, lower back, if you feel it in your discs, tender, okay, body's telling you, back off. So, we're going to make some adjustments, but it doesn't mean that you stop your training, okay? Light bulb is going out. Anyways, so again, it's tight in the hips, tight in the lower back. Okay, and what would you do? And I use it to stretch too. Four. Five. Six. Feel it in your butt. Seven. In your hamstrings. Set number two. Now you see, look, I'm an old tin man. Now even just grab this thing and pull yourself towards. So before I was doing 20 for 3 20s, now we're going to go up to 30 pounds and do 3 15s. Set number two. Third set. tender muscles to release. Feels good. I feel it pulling right in my lower lumbar. Especially a little bit more on the right side than the left. Stretch your hips too. You feel it in your hips. I'm gonna start pulling to the side here like this. I feel it in my left hip mainly, on the inside. And here. Yeah, just grab hold whatever you can. Good stretch. Take your time. Don't rush. Remember, we just trained back, so back's a bit tight for going all the way around, it seems. Just go as far as you can. Swing like a pendulum, like I told you. Allow gravity to do the work for you. Now, when it's releasing and it's tender and sore, I mean, getting up every time is going to be a bit of a challenge, okay? But don't worry about it. Okay? Look, even if I want to grab a hold of this thing, stretch all the way forward. If you're in a gym and there's other things to grab a hold of and try and stretch in a different angle, do it. Okay, there's no wrong answers. Okay, right there, I feel it in here. Oh, and be careful when you're releasing. Okay, like coming back, especially if it's tender. My back is tender. So, okay. That's it for that. Come down. Stick your butt out. Okay. When this hits 60, I'm done my walk. And if you don't have a treadmill, get yourself outside and walk for an hour.